One of the things that we encounter routinely at the center and also in our work out at schools is this challenge of identifying children with reading disabilities. It's a very subtle thing to be able to detect, and it's also not widely understood, which makes detection even that more challenging. One of the more exciting research projects that we've been engaging in recently is a partnership that's been led by Lisa Gable at Lafayette College. She's a neurobiologist who was studying a genetic link to dyslexia in mice. And the way she came to discover this link was through experiments where she had mice who were genetically mutated to have a gene called DC2 that's been linked to a greater susceptibility to dyslexia, and ran them through a Hebb-Williams maze. So those are the traditional physical mazes that mice run through in their tests of working memory and other ways that we test behaviors in animals that then get translated to humans. And so what she found was that the mice who had this this gene knockdown were less efficient and overall less good at completing the task when compared to mice who were not genetically mutated. And so, you know, the next obvious step was, okay, that's great for mice, but then does this translate to the human population? Working with a computer scientist at Lafayette College, she had a virtual maze developed that has different representations of the traditional physical Hebb-Williams maze, and the kids navigate with a joystick through the virtual maze to find a red ball. So the conditions are exactly the same as they are for mice, and in fact in our initial data collection we were out at a school and several of the kids would be completing these trials through the mazes and say, "I feel like a mouse," which is great. We're like, well, there's a reason for that. Our initial findings are showing that link across the genetic, the virtual maze is considered a cognitive task, and then the reading behavior, we're finding those same links hold. So it's exciting because even though our research is still in early stages, what we're finding is that through this non-language based task that is really easy to implement, right? It takes very low level of training and expertise to be able to sit and help the child introduce them to the task and then have them complete it. And so if we can do that, you can potentially make it available to people who don't necessarily have to engage in these very lengthy evaluations. And while it wouldn't say definitively, yes, you are, you know, definitely dyslexic or definitely not, it would certainly give you an indication of the level of risk in a way that would be much more difficult to sort of put off to developmental issues than a reading test would.